there, good afternoon and welcome back to the channel. I saw this lovely old church here in Camelford, just down from where I'm staying. So I thought I'd come down and take a closer look. And it's the church that's called the Parish Church of St. Julita, Lantiglos by Camelford. Really interesting old church. Let's take a look anyway. It's a really old graveyard. That's really interesting. It's a really old church. You can see there by the windows. They're not actually stained glass, but they're LED light. But you can see just by the frames and the stone masonry, it's really, really old. And I passed it last night and this is all lit up inside. It looked really gorgeous. Hence why I wanted to come back and have a quick look today. Take a look at that window. So old. It's a shame I can't get anything from that stone. It's just too badly corroded, so can't see a year. That's 1766. It's a really old tomb. There's a date on this, 1680. Nothing interesting in the grave. Cornish slate with a headstone laid on top. Let's have a look and see if the... yeah, it's a Norman church. Let's have a look inside. If it's open. Beautiful mechanism. Really old font. So it's a really old church because there's actually no stained glass, it's just purely LED light. Windows, a little bit at the top there. didn't have a look under the benches. There's actually stones there where people interred. Very simplistic church. It really is quite beautiful. Hasn't changed in centuries, I would say. If you look at the scrolling on the wood along the top.
The church dates back from the 12th century with a 14th century tower. The six bay south aisle and possibly also the south porch were added in the 15th century. In the 1860s, the church was re-roofed also.
Just look at that old ceiling. It's quite beautiful. I'm just taken by how plain the windows are. Very unusual. Look at that window. Oh, he could do Piccadilly. Down there, just behind the glass, is the pool course for the bells. It's a really old organ. Make out the way the walls are kind of splaying outwards. It really is a beautiful old church. So that bit there at the front you can see is obviously exposed from the plaster or whatever they used in the day to infill. Looks like work still needed. Thank you. And the graveyard actually, as I say, just goes right up the hillside there. Extremely large. Up to this top part of the graveyard. It looks the oldest part. These bluebells are beautiful, aren't they? Just in amongst all the gravestones. Very ornate, aren't they? 1888. There's a view of the church from the top end of the graveyard. You can smell the wild garlic. Seems to be late 1800s up here. Seen that sign before on stones. Looks like a dollar sign. Not sure what the relevance is, but I'll have to see if I can find out. So I've seen it in different graveyards on different stones. An interesting stone. Looks like it's been moved. Actually, you're running water. Looks like there's a stream down there, actually. Bottom of the graveyard. It's unusual. There's some graves that are hidden here. Some really old ones. Look at this one. Really heavy chain. No way of seeing anything on that stone. That's the 1950s. That looks really, old and unusual. Again, there's a different kind of symbol there. Not sure what that symbol equates to. Again, it's like a dollar sign, an S if you like, but different. That water now. It's not quite what I expected to see in the bottom of the churchyard. So that was a beautiful church. Graves or interments for many hundreds of years. So I hope you enjoyed. Again, thanks for joining me on this one, and I'll see you on the next videos. Thanks again. Goodbye.